It's a good March day for skiing at Pat's Peak in Henniker. People on the slopes, happy to be out in the elements.
Go, baby!
But climate change is making it increasingly difficult for New Hampshire ski resorts to function at their best. And the forecast for the future might have those skiers on edge. As the Earth continues to warm, data shows winters are warmer, shorter, and there isn't always reliable natural snowfall.
It is sad for the Northeast, you know, that we'll have more Christmases without snow, a constrained ski season.
Dartmouth College climate scientist Jonathan Winter studies Northeast precipitation. His latest research shows that within the next 80 years, we'll see a 50% decrease in snowfall.
All the projections that I've seen and that I've made myself see more precipitation falling out of the sky. The problem is we're just getting that more and more as rain instead of snow. And then between those snowfall events, warmer temperatures will melt out the snowpack.
Ski resorts are already using advanced snowmaking technology to help deal with that. Pat's Peak is one of the only in the state able to make snow for 100% of its terrain. But it's a big investment.
We're seeing a lot of improvement in terms of the efficiency of the equipment, and we're also seeing a lot of improvement in terms of how high that temperature that equipment will run in.
But despite those advancements, Dr. Alex Contosta, a climate researcher at UNH, says because of the low temperatures needed to make snow, at some point the technology just won't be able to keep up. And that means many Northeast resorts will be forced to close.
But what our research shows is that even with the potential to make snow, that we're going to have such warm temperatures that only 15% of the ski areas that currently exist in the Northeast and in Southern Quebec will be open by the end of the century.
That's a huge loss for recreation, of course, but also economically. From the hotels, restaurants, and other businesses, ski resorts are a $500 million industry in New Hampshire. And winters are not just getting warmer and wetter. They are shorter, too.
We see that the snow melts earlier than it used to. And the temperatures that are conducive to making snow disappear a lot sooner.
Just like what has happened this winter, we're still going to get plenty of storms, but we'll also continue to notice a slow progression of fewer snowy seasons, and the winter season itself will shrink due to warmer temperatures, unless action is taken.
And so it really depends on what we decide to do as a society to reduce emissions, because the worst case scenario is not inevitable.
Meaning the future of skiing in New Hampshire could very well depend on the energy choices people make in the coming decades.
And a lot of those energy decisions come from the state and the federal level. So if that's something that you want to change, both scientists I talk to say you've got to let your representatives know. In next month's edition of Forecasting Our Future, we're talking about our beautiful lakes here in New Hampshire and how climate change is impacting the water quality of those lakes. So watch for that in April. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe, live in Manchester tonight, WMUR News 9.